I said, well, now, in today's session, we are seeing the Dow Jones Industrial Average resuming its rally after yesterday's decline. And in today's session, it was hovering closer to the 34,500 level prior to the start of the US session. And once the session began, we are seeing renewed buying there. And it looks likely that the 35,000 level is going to be reached. It is just a matter of time, maybe today, or it might take a couple of days. But if we consider the price trajectory, we are going to have the price being high, retested again. The all-time high is likely to be bested again. And in course of time, we can even see new all-time highs being established. So if you want to take advantage of this bullish momentum in the Dow, we will of course have to consider the optimum entry points. And that's what this session of Market Movers is going to be about. If we consider the data of it for the day, today the economic release calendar is pretty much light. There were not many releases which might have moved the market. If we consider the European trading hours, we had these German retail sales numbers for the month of April, where we saw that the retail sales have actually declined by 5.5%, which is kind of reversal if we compare it to the prior month's reading, where we had the growth of more than 7 percentage points. And these numbers are actually worse than the expectations, and one of the reason can be the reimposition of some restrictions. And also the April was the month of Easter, and as a result of that, the festivity boost was there for that month. So these are some of the factors which might have contributed to these higher than anticipated numbers. Moving on to the US, we got these MBA mortgage applications for last week, the weekend, the 28th of May. And as the mortgage rates have started to climb, we are seeing that mortgage applications have gone on downward low, though the pace of decline is not that significant, but still decline is a decline. And for the last couple of weeks, we are seeing that the mortgage applications moving lower. And for last week, the reading is lower by 4 percentage points. And if you consider the mortgage rate, which stands at 3.17%, is not much different from what we had in the prior week of around 3.18%. These are average rates, and of course the actual rates vary depending on the credit history and the credit institution. So we will not really go into the details of that, but this was the only significant release for the US, which was released even prior to the start of the US session. And in today's session, we are likely to see the financial instruments moving mostly as per the technical formations, as we don't really have any significant driving factor on the economic as well as on the political side. So let's shift our attention to the technical aspects. First, we will consider the outlook for the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and then we will also see what's happening, what's unfolding in the Euro-USD. Let's start with the Dow Jones Industrial Average technical outlook first. This is the daily time frame chart, and here this consolidation for the Dow has been quite extended. We had this deep and double bottom kind of formation taking place closer to the 33,500, and from there on the Dow began to climb again, though the gains have been incremental, and in yesterday's session the spike was there. But by the time the markets closed, we had the reversal of sort, and in today's session the Dow is picking up from where it left in yesterday's session. And I think this time around it might move in a more sustainable manner. And if we see the closing for today's session anywhere closer to the yesterday's high, I think we are pretty much set to see the 35,000 price area to be retested again. And there is a quite high probability of a new all-time high being established above 35,000 for the Dow, as its bullish trajectory still remains intact, and we have this liquidity coming in from the central bank. And and that is fueling this upward momentum in most of the financial instruments, financial assets. So we are not really likely to see the parity stopping anytime soon, and all we have to do is to keep looking for the buying opportunities wherever we see significant dip and consolidation closer to the support area. So if we want to consider some key levels in today's session, I think the immediate low, the today's session low, should also be a good price area to watch out for. As long as the price action is holding well above the day's low in today's session, we can be fairly confident of the retest of the yesterday's high. And as I said, the prior swing high is likely to be bested again. And if we consider the near resistance, we have this first resistance of this month's pivot point series, which is there around 35,250. So we have almost 2 percentage point room on the higher side for the Dow to climb, and I'm not really expecting the Dow's rally to stop anytime soon. Of course, in the market anything can happen, but we have this formation of higher highs and higher lows, and also if you consider these technical formations of the regression curve and the pivot point series, both are quite conducive for the continuation of this upward momentum. And on the lower side, we do have a significant support in place around 34,300 in form of this central pivot point. So taken together, these factors are pointing to the possibility of the continuation rather than reversal, and all we have to do is look for some key price areas which are going to offer us the best risk reward ratio. So if you want to go for any trade in today's session, I would say that this convergence area of 50 and 100 SMA, which is there around 34,500, is a good bet, and the stop loss can be kept below this 200 SMA. So you will have to take the risk of around 100 to 150 points depending on where you are getting your entry. And if you are fortunate enough, get the entry anywhere in the price band of 34,550 to 34,600, then that will cut down on your risk, as your risk will be quite low if you are going to keep your stop loss lower than these 200 SMA. And on the higher side, you can wait it out till the 35,000 level is reached again. This is the immediate swing high, 34,850, and even if we simply bet on the continuation of these higher highs and higher low formation, even in that sense, we can expect the Dow to climb past these prior swing high. So I think the probability is quite good, but of course it's not like 100%. So we will have to, of course, be mindful of the risk associated with this trade, as is the case with any other trade, and trade accordingly. Keep the risk in mind, and also the reward that can come your way if you are willing to take that risk. Now moving on to the currency side, we will see what's happening in the EURUSD. This is the daily time frame chart, and in yesterday's session we saw the EURUSD climbing to 1.225, and after that, the sharp reversal took place, and in today's session, in the early hours, we even saw the EURUSD dipping fairly close to 1.215, not exactly 1.215, but thereabout. And from there on, it has again climbed back closer to 1.22. And I think moving forward also, the 1.22 level is going to be crucial. And if we consider the price formation for last couple of days, it is consolidating. There is no significant trend present. It is simply consolidating closer to this resistance area. And I think given the failure of the Dow to climb past 1.225, the case can be made for a possibility of a breakout on the lower side, which might take it back to 1.20. So that possibility is there, but for that, we will have to be on watch for the price action in near term, and depending on how the price action plays out in next couple of days, we will have a lot more clarity from medium term perspective. And even if you are simply looking to trade in intraday, even in that case, 1.22 is going to be the price area to watch out for, and it is going to offer us the technicals which are going to help us while deciding whether to go long or whether to go short. So here, as you can see from the chart, we had this support on the lower side closer to the central pivot point, and from there we saw this reversal taking place, and the EURUSD is now trying to climb back from where it had started to decline. But I'm expecting these prior consolidation lows to now act as the resistance and a further dip towards this support area, the central pivot point of this month, can't really be ruled out. So in today's session, the 1.22 price zone is going to be crucial, and if we see the days closing below these prior swing lows, then I think in next session we can expect the decline to start again and get the EURUSD closer to this central pivot point. So if we have to go for the trade in today's session, I would prefer it to be on the short sell side rather than going long on the current levels. But I am not really expecting any big move now that we have already seen it oscillating first on the lower side and then reverting some of the losses. It is more likely that for next couple of hours, the EURUSD might simply consolidate while not moving much. But by the time we come back for trading in the European trading hours, we will have a lot more clarity, and that's why I say we don't really see the EURUSD climbing above the prior swing lows, these price levels of around 1.222. Then the case can be made for shorting it in the initial hours of the European trading hours, European trading session, and that's where the price action is likely to be a lot more decisive. So for this session and for tomorrow's session, this convergence area of 50, 200 and 100 SMA is going to be crucial. We have these three SMAs converging closer to 1.221. We have these SMA at around 1.222, and then on the lower side we have this 100 SMA around 1.220. So I'm expecting this price area to now act as the resistance, given the fact that we had this breakout on the lower side, and the formation is now becoming of a lower low if we look at it from the hourly charting perspective. And even if you consider the prior swing high, even that high was higher than compared to this high established just slightly above 1.225. So in course of time, we can expect the EURUSD to decline toward this prior swing low established in the last week, and that is the reason why I would be cautious in today's session while taking any trade and allow the EURUSD to consolidate first. And with that, the clarity is likely to emerge, and unless and until we have any significant break on the higher side above this resistance area, we can be quite confident of profiting on a short sale trade. All we need to do is wait for some more time, allow the consolidation to take place, and then the immediate swing high, the price area little above this high, I think the price of around 1.223 would also be good enough to be used as a stop loss while looking to enter into the trade anywhere in this convergence zone of around 1.221, and the target can be kept on the lower side closer to the prior swing low. I think the price target of around 1.215 should be good enough given the fact that we have the central pivot point precisely near that area, so we can expect some sort of support on those levels. So that's my take looking at the EURUSD's technical formations. And if you have any query or any idea to share, you can write to me in the feedback section, and I will be more than happy to take the discussion forward. Before I sign off, I would also like to remind of the risk associated with trading the financial instrument, and one should be careful while using the information provided. Have a fabulous day ahead. See you next time. Till then, goodbye.